قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله، لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله، إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.
أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، حمدا بجميع المحامد على جميع النعم حمدا لا يتناهى، ملء السماوات السبع وملء الأرض السبع وملء ما بينهما وملء ما شاء الله من شيء بعد. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين. فاللهم صل على محمد في الأولين، وصل على محمد في الآخرين، وصل على محمد في كل وقت وحين، وصل على محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. Brothers and sisters in Islam, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. وجزاكم الله خيرا، and ask Allah bless you and remember me always in your, in the best of your dua, inshallah. After Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, by the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I finish explanation of التوحيد. Then after that, the details and explanation of shirk. Then after that I move to nifaq, hypocrisy. Then after that I move to also al-kufr, and what is al-kufr, and what the Muslim should know about it. And I start before all of this about al-kabair, the major sin. And alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah and by the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I finish 10 of the major sin. Finish explanation of 10 of the major sin, which it is الشرك بالله, the committing shirk, and murdering or killing. Number 3, it is in black magic, and I explain the details and the ayat about it according to the book of Imam al-Dhahabi. And number 4, leaving or neglecting the salah, the prayers, does not paying the cash, this is number 5. Number 6, breaking the fast of even only day in Ramadan without shar'i reason. Number 7, leaving the hajj while you are able, does not do hajj while he is able to do it. Number 8, being unthankful and not good and disobedient to your parent. This is one of the major sin in Islam, and it is number 8. Number 9, cutting the relation with kith and kin, with the womb relations. Then number 9. Number 10, the last one I explain about adultery and committing adultery. And I said before, there is many different definition for al-kabair, for the major sin. And I'm explaining according to more than one book. One of it is the main one, Muhammad ibn Ahmad ibn Uthman al-Zahabi, the one who died the Hijri year 748. And I said the definition of الكبائر هي كل جريمة نهى الله ورسوله عنها في الكتاب والسنة أو كل ما نص الكتاب على تحريمه. Every crime that Allah or Rasulullah forbid it in the Quran or the Sunnah. وكل معصية فيها حد في الدنيا. Any kind of disobedience to Allah عز وجل or a crime have a punishment in dunya, like the punishment for killing or the punishment for committing adultery or the punishment for stealing. This is this kind of things like killing or zina or adultery or stealing. This is will be counted as one of the major sin. Not only if it is have a punishment in dunya, if it have wa'idun fil akhirah, min adhabin aw ghadabin aw tahdidin aw la'nin fa'ilihi aw ghayrih. If it is have also threatening that in the Akhirah he will be cursed, he will be threatening by a punishment, any kind of punishment, when there is after the crime or a sin described that have punishment in dunya or a punishment in akhirah, this has become a great sin. Or ورد فيها وعيد بنفي إيمان أو لعن أو تبرؤ أو قول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ليس منا أو عذاب أو غضب أو تهديد أو طرد من رحمة الله. If رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم say whoever do so and so in a kind of a crime or a sin or disobeying to Allah, that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said he is not a مؤمن or he is accursed, لعنة of Allah on him, or he is not one of us, or I am innocent from him, or he will have punishment in the hellfire in the hereafter, or anger of Allah and wrath of Allah upon him, or threatening by certain kind of punishment, or he is kicked out from the mercy of Allah. Any word like that coming to kind of sin, this sin because of whatever punishment after it in this dunya, or in the hereafter, or he is cursed, or he is out of rahmatullah, this sin become one of the great sin. About the number of it, there is no, the ulama does not agree upon it. Imam al-Dhahabi, the book he have, he said 70, or near to it. But Ibn Abbas and Sa'id ibn Jubair, they said, أَقْرَبُ إِلَى السَّبْعُمَاءِ مِنَ السَّبْعِينَ. It is near to 770. And كل جريمة تعلم بقلة اعتناء مرتكبها بالدين. Any crime or any sin, it tells you that the one who committed, he does not care about the religion. This has become a great sin. And we ask Allah by His great name to save us from all kind of major sin. And before I start that, from المباحث العقدية المتعلقة بالكبائر ومرتكبها في الدنيا, المؤلف سعود بن عبد العزيز, there is some ayat and some ahadith I like to share with you first. Then going to also before I said, because I already explained about the shirk and kufr and nifaq and hypocrisy and this is part of the major sin. Now, what you should do if you ask Allah save us, if you commit already one of them, tawbah, repentance. I will explain also about the repentance. We said, whatever calamity you have, whatever problems or hardship you have, because of what you commit of sin. Allah said that. Look to Surah Ash-Shura, verse number 42, and verse number 30, and Surah number 42. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, وَمَا أَصَابَكُم مِّن مُصِيبَةٍ فَبِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِيكُمْ ويعفو عن كثير. And whatever of misfortune befalls upon you, it is because of what your hands have earned. It is because of your hands have earned. What your hands have earned. Because of what you commit. Because of the sins you have. If it is a lot, there is a lot of misfortune and hardships and calamities will happen to you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pardon much. Allah pardon, Allah say, ويعفو عن كثير. He forgive a lot. If he count everyone with whatever he commit right away, Allah will never leave anyone. As Allah said that in another ayah. What is the relation between the sin and this fitan or trials or calamities or earthquakes or killing or affliction or any kind of wrong? There is big relation. In Surah An-Nur, Surah number 24, verse number 63, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, فليحذر الذين يخالفون عن أمره أن تصيبهم فتنة أو يصيبهم عذاب أليم. And let those who oppose Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, let those who go against Rasulullah, Rasulullah's commandment, beware. Allah bewaring them. Allah warning them. Beware lest some of fitna, some of disbelief, some of trials, some of afflictions, some of earthquake, killing, overpowered by tyrants, should be full upon them. That means there is relation between the sin and this earthquakes, this calamities, this hardship, this volcanoes, problems happen. And these kind of sin, when you commit, Allah say, Allah does not like it. Surah Al-Isra, Surah number 17, verse number 38, listen to what Allah say. كل ذلك كان سيئه عند ربك مكروها. All the bad aspects of this are hateful to your Lord. Allah does not like the sin, and Allah does not like the one who do fasad, the one who do corruption, the one who commit these crimes. Listen to Surah An-Nisa, Surah number 4, verse number 123. Allah say, الجزاء من جنس العمل. The punishment or the reward, or the reward and or punishment will be according to what you did. Good deeds, it is good reward. Bad deeds, it is punishment. Allah Azza wa Jal say, من يعمل سوءا يجز به ولا يجد له من دون الله وليا ولا نصيرا. Whosoever works evil will have the recompense thereof. Whoever do wrong, he will have the recompense of it. He will have the punishment of it. Do not think that you will do bad and you will do evil and you do corruption and you commit the crimes and you commit the sin, then you will have a good reward. No. Allah doing justice, Allah himself is the justice, and he do justice. From whatever you are doing, you will get. And when you see the result of what you did, do not blame except your own self. Even while you are doing good, then you see the result and you wish to have more, you wish to have more, then do not blame except yourself. You have a chance while you are alive. Take the chance of being alive before you die. Take the chance of being alive before you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you do not have. أَتُحِبُّ أَنْ يَكُونَ النَّاسُ بِزَادٍ وَأَنْتَ بِغَيْرِ زَادٍ. Do you like the people? All of them will have their own provision, their own good deeds, and you don't have nothing in front of Allah. Nobody like that. Then the chance while you are alive. And the same ayah, Surah An-Nisa 1:23, Allah say, and he will not find any protector or a helper beside Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the one who do wrong. There is a relation between also the major sin and al-Iman itself. Iman, we know that increased and decreased. It goes up and down. Sometimes you will have, when you do good deeds, your Iman becomes stronger. And your Iman, your faith, will become higher. When you do commit a crime, your Iman either will go down, 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 or will leave you alone completely. For that, committing crimes, committing wrong, committing the major sin in Islam, it will affect your Iman. إما بنفي كمال أو نفي نور الإيمان أو ما يكون به نفي ما يكون به خضوع لهيبة الله عز وجل أو بإخراجه من دائرة أهل الإيمان إلى مرتبة أدنى في الدين وهي الإسلام فقط ولا نكفر أحدا من أهل القبلة بذنب ما لم يستحله. This كبائر when he anybody committed it will affect his إيمان. Either with his إيمان will not be complete, or his Iman will not have more light enough for him, or will the submission to Allah will not be enough, he will not have the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal, or this committing of this crime will make him to get out completely of the circle of Iman. Only he will be a Muslim, and maybe Muslim by name. But at the same time, as I told you in the lectures of the Kufr, that we do not say upon anybody that he is a kafir because of committing any sin, except if he say this sin is halal and it is right, and he, after already explained to him, he insists of what he is doing. We said one of the definition of the al-kaba'ir, that if it is saying to him that he is laysa minna, he is not one of us. Rasulullah said that whoever commits so and so any kind of sin is not one of us. What does it mean, not one of us? إما تغليظا أو ليس على ديننا الكامل أو خرج من فرع من فروع هذا الدين أو أنه يهجر فليس منا تأديبا له أو أن النبي بريء منه أو أن إيمانه ناقص أو إنها كما هي لا تؤول بأي شيء ليس من المطيعين لنا ولا من المقتدين المحافظين. For that have a lot of meaning. He is not one of us. Either as it is, he is really not one of the Muslims. Or have many other meaning. He is not one of us means he is not have a complete like those Sahaba and the time of Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. He is getting out of one of the branch, not the whole deen, but one of the branch of the deen. Laysa minna also means leave him alone. He is not one of us. Do not deal with him. Because he, as a way of punishment to him, as a way of teaching him that what you do is not acceptable and will not be one of our friend. Or laysa minna Rasulullah say, I am innocent from you. You are not my follower. And this is big also. This is big warning. Or laysa minna means he have very, very little iman. For that he is not one of the people who have a perfect iman. He is not one of the obedience one. He is not one of the real follower. Then now we will move to another thing. What about if you already commit anything of that? Tawbah. Tawbah. Regret. And it tawbah not only by tongue, it is by heart. Feeling regret. And leaving the sin. And going back to Allah. And ask Him, oh Allah, forgive me. فَالتَّوْبَةُ الْإِنَابَةُ وَالْعَوْدَةُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالْأَوْبَةُ إِلَى طَاعَتِهِ مِمَّا يَكْرَهُ مِنْ مَعْصِيَتِهِ. Going back to Allah and feeling so deep regret about what happened and what you did and what you commit. And going back to obedience of Allah, to good deeds. أَتْبِعِ السَّيِّئَةَ الْحَسَنَةَ تَمْحُهَا. After committing any sin, follow it with a good deeds in order to cancel this sin. And have more than one definition. But, as I'm saying, is not by only tongue. It is by mind and by heart. And it is wajib ala kulli mukallaf. It is wajib on every Muslim to repeat the tawbah all the time. As I told you, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to say, كُنَّا نَعُدُّ لِلنَّبِيِّ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ مِئَةَ مَرَّةَ قَوْلُهُ أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ. We used to count for Rasulullah more than 100 times in one count sitting with him. That he say, and repeat, أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهُ وَأَتُوبُ إِلَيْهِ. استغفر الله و الله forgive me. وأتوب إليه and I do توبة. I do repentance to him. For that التوبة repentance, it is واجب. الله عز وجل say in سورة هود, سورة number 11, verse number 3, وأن استغفروا ربكم ثم توبوا إليه. Seek the forgiveness of your Lord and turn to him in repentance. In سورة التحريم, سورة number 66, verse number 8, يا أيها الذين آمنوا توبوا إلى الله توبة نصوحا عسى ربكم أن يكفر عنكم سيئاتكم ويدخلكم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار. Oh, you who believe, توبوا, do توبة, turn to Allah, do repentance, توبة نصوحا, sincere repentance. Because the one توبة is not sincerely. Tawbah is when you go back. If you go back, do again. And when any time you go back to the same sin, go back also to the tawbah again. But it's better for you not to all the time committed into tawbah. Means the tawbah is not sincerely. Because of the sincerely tawbah, with the fear of Allah, with the feeling of regret about what you did, you will never go back to it. عَسَى رَبُّكُمْ أَنْ يُكَفِّرْ عَنْكُمْ سَيِّئَاتِكُمْ. May Allah forgive all of our sin. Say Ameen. And he will make you admit you to Jannah, which there is a lot of, there is a gardens under which rivers flow in al-Jannah. There is also relation between a tawbah and the success. Every one of us, he wish and he like to be success. A tawbah and the relation between tawbah and success, look to Surah An-Nur, Surah number 24, verse number 31. What Allah Azza wa Jal say? وَتُوبُوا إِلَى اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا أَيُّهَا الْمُؤْمِنُونَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. And all of you, beg Allah to forgive you all. All of you, beg Allah to forgive you all. Oh Allah, forgive us. Ameen. Oh believers, that you may be, listen, maybe you will be successful. For that there is the relation between the tawbah, the repentance, and being successful. عن ابن عمر عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال يا أيها الناس توبوا إلى الله فإني أتوب إليه في اليوم 100 times. Oh people, do tawbah for Allah. Was me myself, means Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم, doing tawbah for Allah سبحانه وتعالى and ask and turn to him and ask for and do repentance 100 times. Also, one of the things very good to know. Do you know when we say Salah is ibadah, means a worship of Allah. Zakah is ibadah. Dua is ibadah. Also, Tawbah is ibadah, from the ibadat. Tawbah is worship to Allah. Allah love it, and Allah be pleased with it, from his slave to do Tawbah to him. When you do Tawbah, you know, oh Allah, because you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and you return to him, and you say, oh Allah, I am weak. I know that I did mistake. You confess it to Allah. There is no confess to the human being in Islam. To Allah directly. Allah nearer to you than the blood in your body. Let us now move to the conditions of Tawbah. Listen, number one, nadam, regret and feeling so deep, sorry about it. Number two, al-iqla'u an al-dhanb. Stop doing this kind of sin, no more, or this kind of crime, or this kind of disobeying to Allah. Stop right away, if you really have a real tawbah. Number three, have an intention and a strong will, never go back. These three condition, if the sin itself between you and Allah, but if the sin between you and somebody, you steal some money of somebody, then there is another condition, number four, that an yuaddi al-haqqa ila ashabi. If you steal something from somebody, one of the conditions of tawbah to return it to him in case if there is no bigger fitna will happen. I backbite somebody, ask him to forgive you, because Allah will never forgive you except if this person forgive you. If you come in front of Allah the day of judgment and ask forgiveness, maybe he will not agree. But in the worldly life, yes, you will feel shy and you will feel a little bit down, but it is this down and this shy and this disgracing in the dunya less many times than the hereafter. For that number one, feeling regret, because in Sahih al-Jami' al-Saghir al-Albani 1150 is a hadith number, Rasulullah said an-nadamu tawbah. Nadam is tawbah, alaykum salam. Nadam itself is being feeling regret and feeling so deep sorry and feeling that I should not do that. And feeling a feeling in your heart like a painful feeling. This is itself tawbah. For that the first condition, al-asaf wal-hasrat wal-nadam ala wuku'i al-dhanb min wa-kurhuhu wa-adam wa-tamanna wa-yatamanna allahu lam yaf'alhu. That to feel sorry. For that it is for the saying of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-nadam tawbah. The feeling of regret and feeling of so deep sorry is itself a tawbah. Al-iqla'u an al-dhanb. You have to stop it. إن المؤمن إذا أذنب ذنب كانت نكتة سوداء في قلبه فإن تاب ونزع واستغفر صقل قلبه وإن زاد زادت حتى يعلو قلبه الران الذي ذكر الله عز وجل في قرآنه كلا بل ران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون. When you stop it, narrated by Imam Ahmad and Tirmidhi, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, when you commit a sin, your heart will have a small black dot. And another sin, another black dot, another sin, another black dot, until the whole heart will be covered with this black dot out of committing the sin. And this is what Allah says in Surah Al-Mutaffifin, كَلَّا بَرَّانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. This run, covering of the sin, will make a black dots over the heart, and this is what, because of what they used to earn, because of the sin they commit, because of the haram they do. What you should do, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, فَإِنْ تَابَ وَنَزَعَ وَاسْتَغْفَرْ سُقِلَ قَلْبُهُ. If he do tawbah, this is the first condition. If he do repent to Allah, and he stop doing, and ask Allah to forgive, and feel so regret, and so deep sorry about what he commit, then his heart become clean, and Allah will accept his tawbah. Also have intention. You already stopped. Do not go back to it again. It's better for yourself. Yes, if suppose you committed, you go back to the tawbah and you go back to the sin and repeat it and have a strong will not to do it. Number four, if it is a haqq and if it is a right to somebody else, you have to do tawbah from it also and you have to ask him to forgive you. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم narrated by Imam al-Bukhari, كتاب المظالم saying من كانت له مظلمة لأخيه من عرضه أو شيء فليتحلله منه اليوم قبل ألا يكون دينار ولا درهم إن كان له عمل صالح أخذ منه بقدر مظلمته وإن لم تكن له حسنات أخذ من سيئات صاحبه فحمل عليه. Rasulullah advising us, say if you commit any wrong against anyone, ask him to forgive you in the dunya. In the dunya, in these days, before, there is no dinar or dirham, there is no dollars, there is no money, because you cannot pay him nothing. In the hereafter, what it is, only the good deeds and bad deeds, the good reward and the bad. If suppose Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم say, if he have, إن كان له عمل صالح, أخذ منه بقدر مظلمته. If you already did wrong against somebody, they will take from your good deeds and give it to him, equal to the wrong you did against him. What about if you don't have a good deeds? It will take from his bad deeds, from his bad reward, and from the evil he have, it will be put upon you. For that justice will be heaven. And listen to the saying of Ibn Taymiyyah, and it is so good and so beautiful. Ibn Taymiyyah said, وليست التوبة من فعل السيئات فقط كالفواحش والمظالم بل التوبة من ترك الحسنات المأمور بها أهم من التوبة من فعل السيئات المنهي عنها فأكثر الخلق يتركون كثيرا مما أمرهم الله به من أقوال القلوب وأعمالها وأقوال البدن وأعماله وهم لا يدرون أنهم لا بد من أن يتوبوا من ذلك من ترك المأمور أيضا. He said توبة not only because of committing sin. You must do tawbah when you do not do the good you are ordered to do. When you do not do the salah, you have to do tawbah. When you neglect it sometime, you have to do tawbah. You have to repent. When you do not do whatever will you are ordered to do, of salah, or zakah, or siyam, or sadaqat, or muamalat, or whatever Allah order you, or hajj, while you are able, and you do not do, you should do tawbah then. You go and do it. Not only do tawbah and you still do not pray. Do tawbah and you still do not pay zakah. I'm doing tawbah and still you do not do fasting. No, it will not work. Do tawbah and feel so deep regret, but you still have a chance to do hajj and you did not go. Then Allah will punish you. Do tawbah, then do what Allah ordered you to do. And if it is sin, do tawbah, then do not do it. Now again, tawbah from doing sin and wrong, tawbah also from if you do not do what Allah ordered you to do. What about if I do tawbah from the things Allah ordered me to do, but I did not do it, like a salah. Now, you have to do the salah. Do the tawbah and do the salah. Do the tawbah and do the zakah if you do not do it. Do the tawbah and do the hajj if you did not do it. Do the tawbah and do the sawm, the fasting, if you neglect some time. And if it is the tawbah with the sin, do the tawbah and stop committing the sin again. Do the tawbah and ask Allah to forgive you. And we ask Allah by His great name to forgive us. Inshallah, the next time we'll go on with more details from Kitab al-Zawajir عن اقتراف الكبائر لابن حجر الهيثمي. He said a very beautiful thing. حرم الله الكبائر والفواحش والمناهي والمفاسد والشهوات والملاهي والأهوية والقبائح والمعاصي بقواطع النصوص الزواجر. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make all kind of sin, make all kind of evil, all kind of forbidden thing, all kind of haram, very clear in the Quran and the Sunnah, all kind of evil desires, all kind of wrong, and all kind of things make Allah angry, very clear in the Quran and in the Sunnah. The ayat is very clear about it, and also take admonition from the stories of the nations was before us when Allah destroys them, like the Qawm Lut, when they commit sodomy and commit the haram. And this is what's coming after that, inshallah. Inshallah, after that, we'll explain about the committing the sin of sodomy or homosexuality or riba, using usury, interest, which it is in a lot of systems now. A lot of things, if you look at it, you'll find riba in it. Eating the property of yatim or the orphan. Lying against Allah or lying against Rasulullah when you say Allah said this or Rasulullah said it and he does not say it. Also, when you betray others, betraying is one of the kaba'ir. Imam Ibn Hajar, Imam al-Zahabi, he count that if you betray others, one of the kaba'ir. When you do dhulm, when you do wrong against others, when you transgress the limit, all of this, one of the kaba'ir. We ask Allah to save us from committing any major sin. And we ask Allah to save us from committing any kind of sin. And we ask Allah to make us close to Him. And Allahumma aghfir lana warhamna wa'afina wa'afu anna wa'ala ta'atika a'inna wa min sharri khalqika sallimna wa najjina min kulli makruhin wa su' Allahumma ansurna wa la tansur alayna Allahumma ahdina wa ahdi bina waj'alna sabab liman ihtada wa arihna wa afrihna wa asturna wa la tafdahna. اللهم إنا نسألك باسمك الأعظم الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى واغننا بحلالك عن حرامك وبطاعتك عن معصيتك وبفضلك عمن سواك وجزاكم الله خيرا والسلام.